Hey there guys, what's up? We're back with the Deadly Tower of Monsters Part 2! And guess what?
Air
we're
teleport
keeping on.
Usage.
Ooh.
Jump. While in the air, use teleport. Quickly return to upper floor.
Oh. Okay. How does that help? I don't think that helps me at all. Die, squid man! Shut up, bird. Oh, I can break those. Alright. Warning, enemies coming from below.
You don't want to miss a single minute of this scene. The nuclear end.
Hey, we need
to remind the audience our heroes are climbing a tower. So I needed something that would stick to walls. Originally, we had these web-footed what-have-yous. Not very scary. And then I left some cake out in my trailer, and it was crawling with ants in the morning. And that's when it hit me. What is the most obnoxious thing in the world?
Ants. Prairie thrust. Sorry. Hey, bud. Up we go! I don't think I mentioned this, but Tower Monsters is like a top-down game if you didn't notice, but more balls on your baton. Now with a pointy end. Oh. I can do... Whoop! Hi, apes. Credence, human. Do you know what these glass huts are for? Yeah. I slept inside one of these glass huts once, and I woke up a week later. Go in. Change characters. I'm gonna be dick. I watched when he went inside. He vanished. Okay, blue cock.
Oh, ooh. No! This head belonged to my co-pilot robot. He was the most loyal companion in the galaxy.
That's who the robot was.
Dick. Malfunction. Dick. Ha. Malfunction.
These Gravorians will pay dearly for this, my friend.
Now, what's a space adventure film without a trusty robot sidekick, huh? Am I right? In the original draft, we had Dick and Scarlet team up with an alien from the planet's surface. You know the type, pointy ears, wise and emotionless. But then we came to our senses and realized that a giant tin can robot's way cooler. Besides, everybody was
Spock.
Doing the alien thing back then. You know me, I'd rather be a trailblazer.
Where am I going? Wait. I gotta say, this reminds me of... You know the Star Wars games? It's the Lego Star Wars games? You know them, right? So, Lego Star Wars... Whatever the one that was that had the... That was the, third and fourth... Like, the third and fourth movies and stuff. Fourth, fifth, and sixth. Hey! That's what I thought. But you know the fourth, fifth, and sixth Star Wars movies? Where, when there was in the sixth movie and they had the Lego mission for that one, at the Sarlacc pit? When you play as R2-D2 and fly, you have to fly around on the puzzles and stuff. This is what it reminds me. This reminds me of that. It's kind of weird, but it does. Oh. Near an acrobatic, an acrophobic. Oh, I upgraded it. Oops. Oh well, I upgraded it. What? No, I want my. Oh, okay, Taser and Sparky and Tesla gun. I want to keep the Tesla gun. Okay. Revolver. I climbed up here because I saw something shiny on the side of the tower. I'm too afraid to look over the edge so high up. That is the sound of the late. This is the Star Wars sound.
Company made us install those safety guards after our actors fell off the set one too many times. Granted, they kept falling off even with the rails, but thanks to how the contract was laid out, we were no longer liable for their injuries.
Really? I'm an astronaut. Hey there. The great Mega Gorilla used to protect us. Now he serves the Emperor. That gosh darn Mega Gorilla.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I guess it's time to talk about the elephant in the room. Why on earth does this crazy film have title cards on screen when people are talking? You're thinking that, aren't you? I know you are. I would be too. Well, we had thought about making it a silent film at one point, so we shot a lot of scenes up close like this, with the dialogue written out for the audience to read. Well, when
no.
We swapped over to making a talkie, well, we just decided to keep on going rather than reshooting all those scenes.
Good point, man. It's like little dirigibles. I like them. They just explode. I love that noise. I love the noise. That is so like Han Solo's blaster pistol, at least. Actually, no. Get me down from here. Over here. I like this. I'm more relaxed than normal. Yeah, I'm not like oh, 20 minutes is up. Gotta go. Oh. Why? Okay, whatever. This is amazing. I love this game. This game has like, it has the soundtrack of an older, like an old 70s, 80s sci-fi type movie. It's got humor too. I love that. But I suck at it. Why can't I get up? No. No, those look like big socks. I feel like he's gonna the commentary director's gonna mention that at some point. I also love how, like, Dick Starspeed's voice. And he has such an older, like, old, bad sci-fi, or not bad sci-fi, but sci-fi name, Dick Starspeed.
Ah, the best part about being in showbiz, craft services. It's like never-ending supply of free food all day long. I never had to pay for a single meal. Hey, Patrick, I noticed you guys don't do that here in your studio. You should talk to your boss. Maybe even just a bagel station.
Wait. Door to the engine room? Okay, I can't get up there. The engine room. The engine room we go. Hey. Get out of here. Okay, got him.
Picking science community also complained about these Terra whatever's breathing.
Terra whatever.
Like there's fossil evidence of dinosaurs not ever shooting fireballs. It's not like I gave them neck frills or had them spit poison or anything ridiculous.
My god. Dilophosauruses, right? Yeah, that's what they're called. One sec. That's probably Dilophosaurus. Sure, Dilophosaurus. I'm gonna just go with Dilophosaurus. If I'm wrong, and whoever watches this is gonna scream at me in the comments saying, you fart, you idiot, you're an idiot, you're wrong. And be like, oh, but I know, and I'm sorry, it is, I don't know everything. Okay, I haven't even tried to test the gun yet. Might suck. Wow, it takes... Please stay back, human. I must keep this wheel turning. If I stop, the tower will be destroyed. Stop. I will take my brother's place when he collapses, and another will take my place one day. That is called a depressing life. I don't have a gold gear, so I can't upgrade. Well, can I upgrade the Morningstar? Now it looks like a cool morning.
As luck would have it, the next lot to ours was filming some horror movie set in Transylvania. So we signed a soft contract with them to use their set after they wrap for the day. And by that, I mean we kind of snuck in and filmed it real quick when no one was looking. I had my assistant Phyllis keep a lookout for the security guard.
Big rocks. Yeah. Oh! No. Hey! No! No! There's not a lot of Healy stuff in here. Pew pew! No! I'm gonna kill you! Okay. Check start speed! I can't get hit, so... Oh, I guess I can get hit a little bit. Pew! What? Oh, this way. Die! Oh, I got him. Let's keep going. Pew. Slam pow. landmines. Oh.
Hey, most days, the effects team really nailed it. Dinosaurs, saucers, hey, you name it. But these, deflating rock, boulder, cubes, not their best work. This looks kind of odd, if you ask me, like giant whoopee cushions.
I like
they
giant
said they could add some debris and explosions or two afterwards, and then we ran out of budget. Well, to be fair, we ran out of budget several times, but still, I lost a lot of sleep over these rocks.
I'm gonna go back with those rocks back here. Guess I was supposed to anyway, so. Get out of here, pterodactyls! No! 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 Got them, buddies! No! Okay, let's keep going. Let's blast. Gotta blast. Funny jokes. I'm a funny person. Dang it. Bam. It's the fist. I thought I was gonna be stuck there for a second. I was like, dang it. Oh. Dick Star Speed. What? Why am I back here?
Even though we created these conveyor belts for Stacy's character, Jonathan was always trying to run across them to no avail. I probably should have told him that we slowed the belt down whenever Scarlet runs across, but I got a real kick out of watching him try.
Okay. I'm gonna go become Scarlet. Or, I don't know what her name was. It wasn't Scarlet, it was Scarlet's actor. He's Jonathan, but he's Dick Starspeed and she's something. How are you? I still have cool lasers and stuff. Whoa! Hey. Yay. I made it. Are you proud of me yet? Hey. I am.
We first tried this one with regular logs. Well, that was disastrous. I'll tell you, never mess with physics. It was kind of, well, to be frank, it started out nice, but then, it was a death trap. Just plain and simple, it was a death trap. Poor kid holding the boom almost broke his leg. Guess he played basketball in college or something, because he leaped right at the last second. Woo! Crisis averted. My props guy wanted to swap them with some spongy material for safety, but I had a better idea. Let's set the logs on fire.
Oh,
and the
yeah.
Crew be sure to be safe dealing with them.
Obviously. Because then they won't touch them because they're on fire, right? air teleport until you make it.
Say, you know what I was thinking? With all this jumping and climbing and jumping, wouldn't this make a great video game? Isn't that what all those video games are about? Jumping around?
Well, yeah, and killing. There's jumping too, but mostly the killing.
What? Patrick, that's awful. What sort of example are we setting for our youth?
Well, movies are pretty violent too. Your heroes have killed everything in sight. You had Dick shooting a dinosaur in the face in the first 5 minutes.
Well, Patrick, that's different, you know? What we did on film, that was art. Video games aren't art.
Then everyone's like, oh my god! Video games are art. I mean, they are. Okay. One sec. I guess I'll end this after I upgrade. I can upgrade the Shiv. Or I can upgrade the Test. Or I can upgrade the Mace. I'm gonna upgrade the Mace. Dang it. I'm just saving that event so I can upgrade my Mace. Okay, checkpoint Temple's Altar. Well. We are being punished for not doing work. It's too late for us. Save yourself. Escape the planet, human.
Funny story about the two caged apes in this scene. I had completely forgotten about them when we wrapped up filming on the set. Then we spent the next day doing a location shoot. So suffice it to say, our return to the studio was met with a couple of grumbling tummies complaining about unsafe work conditions, human rights, yada, yada, yada.
All right, well, I'm going to end this episode here. Hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you in the next episode. I'm liking this game a lot so far.